I'm just getting ready for a camping trip to Glencoe. Getting everything charged up, I've got stuff charging everywhere. Drone batteries, controller for the drone, camera batteries, pad as well so we can view what's happening with the drone. GoPro batteries down here charging. I've got my batteries charging here as well. Stuff charging absolutely everywhere, much to Laura's delight.
It's Monday the 8th of August. I've actually got a week off work and I'm allowed out to play one night this week. This is looking the best weather wise, so I've decided to grab all my stuff, all my boys' toys, drone, camera, head up to Glencoe, do a bit of photography and videography. Put a wee video together for YouTube. Weather's looking great, not so good here, but Glencoe's to be clear skies up till about 1 a.m. Back to the exact same spot. I was at a couple of weeks back where I got some nice pictures, the weather wasn't too good. So hopefully a bit better tonight, but I'm not the exact spot. I'm back to get the exact same composition. Hopefully get some light trails running right through the valley of Glencoe. Hopefully if it's clear enough and dark enough, get some star shots as well. That's the plan, we'll see how we get on. That hill just right in front of us here, that's the hill I'm going to camp at the top of. Ben Acrulist, I think it's called. Just might turn this corner. You'll see part of the composition I'm going to get right through Glencoe, right through the valley there. That's Buccleuch of Moher on the left there. Curved ridge in the shadows here. A few spits of rain, but that was the forecast anyway this time. And it's to clear up. Couple of hours time, clear skies. Hopefully it does. Anyway, I'll be parking the car just 2 minutes up the road here. Get out and I'm climbing up there. Spent the next 15 to 20 minutes trying to capture this amazing image of Glencoe. The sun was just appearing from behind the clouds every now and again. It was casting really long sun rays right down on the valley floor. A mixture of the sun rays and the clouds moving pretty fast was creating these amazing long shadows. As it was mid-afternoon, the sun was still pretty high in the sky, and it was blown out in a lot of my pictures when I was trying to capture this image. But I'm still pretty pleased how it turned out. Visit Scotland actually added this to their Instagram page, which I was absolutely delighted about. I'll add the link to the bottom of the video if you want to check that out. I decided at this point that I was going to pack my stuff away and head back down to the car. It looks alright in the video, nice and sunny, but it was very, very windy and the wind was getting worse. It was definitely too strong to fly a drone about in that wind. And it was far too windy to put a tent up. It would have took me ages trying to get the tent up. So after carrying all that heavy gear up there, I decided to head back into the car and head further through Glencoe, try and get another bit to camp. That's me further down Glencoe. Gonna jump out here. Yeah. Just in front of the car there, there's a wall. I'm gonna walk up the side of that. There's a path takes you right up to the top of a wee hill there. I'm gonna hopefully get up there and get a spot to camp. Bit more sheltered than here. But we'll see how we go. Still get cracking views right down the glen. There's some cracking clouds behind us already. It's looking good. But we'll see how we go. Set up. Yeah, I'm gonna get something to eat. Got a pot in the middle there. Get the stove on, get that. Get a bit of heat in me. It's absolutely freezing with that wind. And then I'll head back out. Once it's dark, see if there's any stars out. Just waiting a few cars driving by. Trying to set up my focus now. It's a lot harder when it's dark. I'm just trying to capture some light trails. Take me a few test shots. Once it gets a bit darker, I'll put it on the bulb mode so I can just track one car the full length of the valley. I don't know if you can see that or not on the screen, but the trails are going right through the valley. Looks amazing. Good bit of movement in the clouds because there's still a breeze as well. Zooming a bit. I like trails, that's my card in there. I'll need to Photoshop that out. The focus is spot on, so I'll just leave that locked at that. I'll just keep taking pictures now. Till I make sure I've captured the full length of the road. That's where the car's coming round there. So I'll just leave this on bulb mode until every single one of them has drove by. I've got my ISO right down at 100 because I've got it in bulb mode. I can put the ISO right down, so I'm going to get less noise, which is always a good thing. It's 12:30. And that's me back in the tent when I settled in. I'm going to try and settle down anyway. Absolutely buzzing, got some amazing pictures that I cannot wait to get back and edit. Didn't think it was going to be as clear a night, but it's been absolutely crystal clear. There's a few clouds away in the horizon, but it's very, very clear. Loads and loads of stars are out. Got a few shots of Milky Way, tent in the foreground, Milky Way in the background. And then even get one at the end there that you'll see as well, with my feet dangling at the tent, right at the front door of the tent.
Milky Way is just straight in front of the tent, above the hills. It's absolutely amazing. Most of the time when I get the Milky Way, it's sheer fluke. I never really plan to be just my tent facing in a certain way, or as I said, I thought it was going to rain, so I just positioned the tent behind a big rock here to get a bit of shelter for the wind, and it worked out absolutely amazing with the Milky Way, but just sheer fluke. This is what photography's all about, getting involved, getting out, camping out, staying amongst the elements. Enough of me talking absolute shite. Night night, catch you on the flip side.